Good afternoon, and welcome to today's YouTube broadcast of Homewood Fossmoor at Kenwood Baseball at Homewood Fossmoor. I apologize, as earlier we had some technical difficulties getting the stream up. We are back up now, ready for some afternoon baseball. It's a beautiful day, about 60 degrees here in Homewood Fossmoor, so we're ready for some baseball. Score right now is 2-0 Kenwood Baseball. It's the top of the second inning. We are back. Nice catch there by Heidelberg. That'll be a first out of the inning. Like I said, score is 2-0 Kenwood. Kenwood hit two home runs, top of the first inning. Both solo shots. Humes got out of the inning after that. Peterson with the triple there. Ellis tried to make a diving play but couldn't come up with it. Gets the third on play. I'm sorry, that was Luster with the triple. Humes comes set. The pitch. Called strike one, fastball painted on the outside corner. Up to bat is Junsta Peterson. Set, the pitch. Off speed in the dirt, call for ball one, counts 1-1. Fastball down the plate, fouled off. It'll be 1-2. This is the Vikings' opening day in the season. Humes' first start. Kenwood's first game as well. Humes sees the sign and the pitch. Swing and a miss, strike three. Drop third, he's tagged out on the play. And he's out. Now coming up to bat is Antonio Porterfield. Two outs on the inning. He's the ninth hitter playing first base today for Kenwood. Gives nods, comes set, and the pitch. Off speed, nice pitch by Humes there for a swing and a miss strike, number one. One out triple early in the inning. We'll see if Humes can leave him stranded. Set, here's the pitch. Outside fastball, high and away. That's called for ball one. It'll be 1-1 on the count. Huge crowd here for Homewood Fossmoor. local leagues coming out to support the Vikings. Munoz gives a sign. Here comes set. And the pitch. Inside off speed. Inside changeup for ball two. Count is 2-1. Homewood Flossmore has a new coach on the air, Marcus Rogers, as John McCarthy departed, went to Lincoln Way East. Here's the pitch from Humes. Fouled off. Way to left. Porterfield was late on the pitch, and it'll be 2-2. Let's see what Humes goes with here to get the put out. After a foul ball, the count is 2-2. Humes on the mound, comes set. And the pitch. Low, hits the plate. And the runner from third is going to come home. Took an awkward bounce off the bottom or the front of the plate. Bounced super high in the air, went all the way to the backstop. It'll be 3-0 Kenwood. Full count here, two outs. Looking for the put-away pitch. Humes the pitch. A little blooper into center field. Chaney going out. Morales going out. And Morales makes the catch. That'll be a third out of the inning as the Vikings escape. It'll be 3-0 Kenwood going into the bottom of the second. You're watching HF Viking Baseball. Williams is going to lead it off in the bottom of the second for the Vikings. His first at-bat of the season. Downs with a... facing four batters in the first inning. Chaney got a walk. First leadoff batter of the inning. Was then later thrown out on a singer on a hit trying to score at home. Downs from the windup and the pitch. Williams pops it up. Catcher and third baseman making a play. And it's going to land in foul territory. Foul ball. No catch. Downs wind up and the pitch. Off speed low, tried to frame it, but he doesn't get the call. It's 1-1. Nice little slurve there from down. Catcher tried to frame it in the right corner, didn't get the call. Another pitch is a fastball. It's fouled off. It'll be 1-2. the box. Wind up. And the pitch from down. Way high. Above Williams' head, it's going to be 2-2. High velocity fastball up above his head. Williams did not come close to biting. Down steps off real quick. Maybe trying to reset a little bit. Downs with the third pitch. Off speed off the plate. That'll be out number one on the inning. And here comes Arthur Stamps. The right fielder for the Vikings taking his first at-bat of the season. Downs sees the sign. Here's a windup and the pitch. It's high and inside, ball one on Stamps. Buster trying to frame many of the pitches. Stamps drives one. That's deep left field. It's got a chance. Gone! Arthur Stamps with the home run to left center field. And that'll get the Vikings on the board. It's 3-1 Kenwood. Gives the Vikings a spark of energy that they definitely needed to get back in this game. Stamps with a shot to left field. First home run of the season for the Vikings. And Kenwood is now only up two. It's 3-1 Kenwood. Here comes Calamino trying to follow up what he just saw. Pitch is fouled by Calamino. It's going to be 0-1. Called strike there on Calamino. It's going to be 1-2. Downs gets a sign, a windup, and the pitch. Calamino ground ball to second. Field it, throw to first. He's out. That'll be a second out of the inning. Here steps to the plate Kendall Ellis, seventh batter in this lineup. Downs, windup, and the pitch. Low hits the plate. It'll be ball one. Downs tried to set him up first pitch with the off-speed there. Ellis didn't bite. It'll be ball one, 1-0. Downs from the windup, and the pitch. Rope down the third baseline, and that'll be a two-out hit for Kendall Ellis. Third baseman tried to make a diving play but couldn't quite reach it. It'll be a two-out single for Kendall Ellis. Coming to the plate now is Mateo Munoz. First pitch is outside. It's called ball one. 1-0 on Munoz. Ellis takes his lead from first. Downs looks over. He's set. And the pitch. Right down the pipe fastball. That's strike number one. 1-1 on Munoz. Down set. Pitch number three of the at-bat is a swing and missed by Munoz on a high fastball. It'll be 1-2. Alice with an aggressive lead from first. Downs looks over. He comes set. And the pitch. It's an off-speed in the dirt. It'll be ball number two. 2-2. Good stop there by the catcher to prevent Alice from getting from first to second. Downs looking at the sign. He's set. Lifts his leg and the pitch. It's fouled off the left side by Munoz. Check out a replay on that foul ball. Downs comes set. And the pitch. It's low in the dirt. Catcher can't find it. Ellis will go to second. Maybe make a big turn. He'll not advance to third. At second he is. Count is now 3-2. Two outs with a runner in scoring position. Let's see if Munoz could drive him in. Down set. Lifts leg and the pitch. It's high. Munoz will get the walk, and up to bat will come Mateo Morales. Morales coming to plate with runners on first and second. He's the ninth batter in the lineup. Cheney on deck. And now the coach of Kenwood calls a timeout. Maybe go talk to his pitcher. Make sure they get this third out and don't flip the lineup over. Rogers calling his base runners and hitters over to third base. Telling them situational awareness. So players will disperse. It'll be Mateo Munoz coming up to bat. He's a ninth hitter of the lineup, like I said. Catcher jogging back. Munoz steps up to the plate. Two outs, runners on first and second. Downs come set. Catcher ready, here's the pitch. Way high. Catcher pump fakes at second base. It's going to be ball one on Munoz. Or Morales. That ball was very high. Ellis took a big lead at second. Pump faked at him. Downs with the second pitch. It's a swing and a miss right down the middle by Morales. Fooled him with the changeup there. Downs ready. And the pitch. High again. High and inside there on Morales. It's going to be 2-1. Downs come set. Ready for the third pitch of the at-bat. And the pitch. It's grounded to third by Morales. Third baseman will just take it right to third, get the easy out. But the Vikings do score on the Arthur Stamps power shot to left center field by Stamps. At the end of the second inning, the score is Kenwood 3, Homewood Flossmoor 1. Now at the plate for Kenwood is Kamari Thomas. He's the center fielder. Humes with the third pitch. That's a strikeout for Humes. And it'll be one out for the Vikings. Stepping up now for Kenwood is Demarion Butler. He's starting at shortstop for Kenwood today. Humes winds up and the pitch is low and away off speed for ball one. Second pitch is right down the pipe for strike number one. It's 1-1 on Butler. Hume set. He winds up. And the pitch is low and away again on the fastball. It's going to be 2-1 on the shortstop. Humes winds up again. Pitches an inside fastball. Almost hits Butler. He had to back away. Count is going to be 3-1 now. Humes winds up. Pitches a fastball. He gets jammed. Chaney comes up, fields it. Throw to Heidelberg. He's out. Out number two on the inning. Inside fastball jammed Butler. Hit it with low velo to shortstop Chaney, and Chaney gets the third out of the inning, or second out of the inning. Humes now winds up the pitch. Inside changeup, nice pitch there by Humes. Gets the big whiff from Flowers. Flowers takes a minute to reset. Humes getting the signs from Munoz. Flowers will step back into the box. Humes is ready. Here's the windup. And the pitch. It's high and away. Fastball there on Flowers. Count is now 1-1. Humes with yet another windup and the pitch. It's a fastball hit right up the middle. Chaney diving, he cannot make the play. It's going to be a single for Savion Flowers. Here comes number 7, Jimmy Downs. He's starting pitching for Kenwood. Also knocked a solo home run in his first at-bat in the first inning. Thomas knocked a solo home run. Butler and Flowers then retired. And Downs knocked the second home run of the first inning for Kenwood. Hume set and the pitch. Fastball right on the outside corner. Great pitch there, called for strike number one. Hume's looking at the runner on first. Comes set. And the pitch. It's a low and away off speed. Great block there by Munoz to prevent the runner from advancing to second. Looked like a low and away slider that just got away from Humes. Bounced in the dirt, but a great block there from Munoz. Munoz gives the signs. And Downs calls timeout. Stepping away from the box to reset. Humes gets a sign. Checks over there on Flowers. And he picks off. And it gets away from Heidelberg. Tips off the glove and Flowers is going to advance to second. Pick off there by Humes. Maybe Heidelberg wasn't expecting it. Just tipped off the glove and got away. So Flowers will be at second. Runner in scoring position for Downs with two outs in the inning. Count is 1-1. Munoz gives the sign. Humes with the pitch. It's a fastball tipped into Munoz's glove for strike number two. It's 1-2. Fastball right down the pipe by Humes. Downs tipped it, but Munoz got it. It's going to be 1-2. Humes looking for a put-away pitch. He's set, and the pitch. It's a fastball fouled back. It'll remain 1-2. Foul back up towards the press box there. Munoz getting the sign. He gives it to Henry. Humes comes set. Looking back at the runner on second and the pitch. It's a low and inside slider there on downs. Humes pumped. He gets the out. That'll be out number three. Vikings will get away from the inning with no damage. Going into the bottom of the third, the score is Kenwood 3, Homewood Fossmore 1. Chaney up to bat, hits a grounder to third, hustling it out, field it, and he's thrown out. It'll be out number one on the inning. Chaney took the second pitch he saw, hit a liner right to third, but it was fielded and it was thrown out. Now, Ricky Hamm stepping up to the plate. His second at bat of the game, 0-1 on the day. Low curveball there by Downs in the dirt. It's going to be a 1-0 on him. Downs with the windup and the pitch. It's lined to center by Ham, and it's going to get down. It's going to get past the center fielder. Ham's going to hustle the second. He's going to be in at second with the double. Nice knock there by Ham. We'll check out the replay. Line straight to center. Center fielder almost diving, but he missed the hop. Ham gets right back to second. And now it'll be Demir Heidelberg up to bat, his second at bat of the day. Ham leading off of second. Down set, looking him back. Here's the pitch. Low curveball there. Heidelberg pops it in the air to center. It's going to be caught. No tag on the play. Ham will remain at second. So it'll be two outs. And up to the plate is number 25, Cameron Williams. Williams 0 for 1 on the day with the strikeout. On deck is Stamps. Downs comes set. And the pitch is low in the dirt. Hamill advances to third. It gets away from the catcher, Luster. It's out towards the right side. And now Williams will look to bring Ham in with a knock. Downs with the windup. It's high and inside. Almost hit Williams. It's going to be 2-0 on him. Downs going from the windup with the runner on third. Ham not a threat to steal home. Another high fastball there on Williams. It'll be 3-0 on him. Downs with the windup. The pitch. Williams knocks it to the right side. It's going to be a foul ball out of play. Downs from the windup. The pitch, 3-1. Going to be popped up in the air, high between the shortstop and third baseman. Shortstop will call it. He'll make the catch. So Vikings leave one stranded at third. At the end of third, it's going to be 3, Kenwood, Homewood, Fossmore, 1. Hume's headed back out to the mound for his fourth inning. Allowed 3-3. 2 solo home runs given up in the second. And a run given, I'm sorry, 2 solo home runs given up in the first. 1 run given up in the second. Hume's with the windup and the pitch. To ground ball to Chaney. Fields it, throw to first. Heidelberg makes the catch. That's out number 1. 1 pitch, 1 out for Hume's. Stepping up to play is number 42, Destin Edwards. Called strike there from Humes. Humes with the windup pitch. is low and away. Munoz couldn't scoop it. It'll be ball number one. Hume's wind up. The pitch is high and inside. Almost hit Edwards. It'll be 2-1 on the count. Wind up again. The pitch. There's another high and inside fastball. It'll be 3-1 on Edwards. Hume set. Wind up in the pitch. Is nailed to left field, but Ellis barely has to move. He'll make the catch. Out number two on the inning. So two straight retired for Humes. And up to the plate will step Daniel Luster. Humes wind up the pitch. Fastball right down the pipe for strike number one. Great pitch there by Humes. Humes wind up the second pitch. Another fastball down the middle called for strike number two. Luster will now be in a hole. He's 0-2. Humes with the wind up, the pitch. It's low and outside. It'll be 1-2. Humes set the windup and the pitch. It's a low and away off speed. Luster just reaches for it, pokes it to center field. It's caught by Calamino for a third out. So 1-2-3 inning for Humes there. So Kenwood fails to score any. Going into the bottom of fourth, Kenwood 3, Homewood Flossmore 1. So Stamps is going to come up to the plate. He's 1-for-1 on the day with a solo shot to left center field. Right over the little Viking logo. Trying to repeat what he did in his last at-bat. Get the Vikings within one. Kenwood infield having a meeting at the mound. This is Downs' fourth inning. Allowed 1-1 through 4. Downs is set. The windup, the pitch. It's a low and away curveball. Ball one on Thames. Downs wind up again. The pitch. Swing and a miss by Stamps. Outside fastball there from Downs. Stamps couldn't get a finger on it. Downs wind up the pitch. Low and way outside there. It's going to be 2-1 on Arthur Stamps. Stamps starting in right field today. His first start on varsity was on junior varsity last year. The pitch, swing and a miss there again from Stamps. In his first at-bat as a varsity starter, Stamps nailed one over the left center corner, got him out of play. It'll be 2-2. So now Munoz up to bat. Runners on second and third for him. On the Munoz double. Morales fouls it off. 1-1 on the count to Morales. Here's the windup. The pitch from Downs. It's low and away. Stopped by the catcher. Ellis will not advance home. It'll be 2-1 here on Morales. Looking to potentially tie this game with a hit to the outfield. Both runners in scoring position, so could easily knock this game up. Downs wind up the pitch. It's fouled back towards the press box. It'll be 2-2 here on Morales. Down to wind up the pitch. Morales fouls it off again, just staying alive here. It'll remain 2-2. Downs with the wind up the pitch. Gets away. Ellis trying to come home. He's safe. Called safe home. Let's check the replay on that one. The pitch just got away from the catcher. Pitcher wasn't covering home. He didn't quite know what to do. And Ellis just slid around the tag. Pitcher was covering home, but catcher didn't quite know where to do it. He thought he could run back and tag Ellis on his own, but he was wrong. So Ellis will score, and that'll make the Vikings only down by one. The score is now Kenwood 3, Homewood Fallsmore 2. Now Kenwood having a meeting at the mound. Already been two controversial calls at home plate. First one, Torrey Chaney being called out at home in the first. Maybe a bit of a makeup call there with Kendall Ellis at home. Regardless, score is 3-2. Full count here on Morales. Downs with the pitch. That is shot to center by Morales. It's back on the track, but it's caught by the center fielder. Nice shot there by Morales. Just didn't have the distance to get out of here. So at the end of the fourth inning, it is 3, Kenwood, Homewood Fallsmore 2. You're watching Homewood Fallsmore Viking Baseball. So new pitcher here for the Vikings. It'll be Trent Roseboro, senior. His first pitching appearance for the Vikings. Was the starting quarterback for Homewood Fossmore football team before he got season-ending injury. Now looking to redeem that in baseball. So it'll be his first appearance here for the Vikings, facing Jonathan Patterson here to lead off the inning. Humes with a solid 4 innings, 3 runs allowed on the day as his day comes to an end. Trent with the windup and the pitch. It's a ground ball. Diving play by Morales, but he's not going to get the throw in time. Patterson will beat it out. Nice diving stop there by Morales. Just didn't get it in time to throw it to first. So it'll be a runner on first. No out. And up to the plate is Antonio Porterfield. Roseboro getting the sign. Looks at the runner on first. He comes set. Steps off the mound in an attempt to pick. Does not get the throw over, however. Taking a solid lead over there at first. He does throw over this time. Does not get the runner. He's back in time. Roseboro comes set for the pitch. Bunt shown, and a bunt is put down. Munoz will get it. He'll throw to second. The throw is wild. They do not get the out at second. So it'll be a successful bunt. Attempted to throw out at second. Does not get the out. So runners at the corners with nobody out. An attempted sacrifice, but they tried to get the runner at second, but throw is wild there by Munoz. Like I said, runners on first and third, and up to the plate is Kamari Thomas. Started off the game today with a solo shot to center field. First at bat of the season. So Roseboro gets the sign. Runners on the corners, maybe kind of steal. He comes set in the pitch. Another bunt shown, but it's pulled back and called for a strike. Roseboro comes set. The pitch is a low curveball taken for a ball. It's 1-1 here on Thomas. Roseboro set. A leg kick, the pitch. It's a curveball pounded to center field. It's back, and that's going to be a second home run of the day. Off speed, just thrown right down the middle. It's pounded. It'll be 6-2 Kenwood. So now with two home runs in the opening game of the season. Nice start there for Kamari Thomas. Now stepping up to play is going to be Damarion Butler. Roseboro with the windup, the pitch. It's popped in the air. Heidelberg's going to call for it, and he'll make the catch. So first out there on the inning. Big one there for Roseboro. Now here comes the right fielder, Savion Flowers. Roseboro just trying to reset, forget about the home run. So with one out of the inning, Flowers steps up. Roseborough again, the sign, the wind, the kick, the pitch. Swing and a miss. Nice pitch there by Roseborough. Fooled him with the off-speed. Nice change up there. It'll be 0-1. Thomas super early on the swing. Couldn't quite time it up. Maybe he thought a fastball was coming. Roseborough out. I wind up the pitch. Outside and away. It's going to be 1-1 here on Flowers. Roseborough with the windup, the pitch. It's another nice changeup there. Flowers early yet again. Can't seem to time up the changeup here. Let's see if Roseborough goes back to it a third time in the at-bat. Here's Roseborough. He's set. The wind, the pitch. Nice curveball there. Called strike three. Two outs there on the inning. Down, stepping up to the plate now. Four solid innings for the Broncos with only allowing two runs. He'll ground it up the middle. It'll get through. Two out single there for Downs. First pitch curveball attacked, grounded right up the middle. Stepping up now is the third baseman, Philip Thigpen. A pinch runner put in for Downs. Roseborough checks on the runner at first. He comes set. The pitch. Super high. Maybe let the curveball go a little too early. It'll be 1-0 here on Thigpen. Roseborough, winding the kick, the pitch. It's a ground ball there to Ham. I'm sorry, a line out there to Ham. Was low, looked like a ground ball, but he caught it. He's called out. That'll be a third out of the inning, and we'll go to the bottom of the five. Scores: Kenwood 6, Homewood Fossmore 2. Stepping up to the plate now is number 0, Torrey Chaney. Has a walk on the day. Downs coming back out now for his fifth inning. Allowed two runs through four so far, along with a home run from Stamps. Chaney drives one. That's deep left field. Same place as Stamps. It's way out of here. Hits the tree. Torrey Chaney with the solo shot. Same place as Stamps. Let's check the replay on that one. Chaney with a deep drive. He watched it fly. He knew that one was gone. Torrey Chaney with a solo shot now. So it'll be 6-3 Kenwood. Vikings have two home runs on the day. Unluckily, both solo shots for him. So now Ricky Ham stepping up to the plate. Downs with the pitch. That's a ground ball. It gets through between short and third there from Ham. So it'll be a runner on first with no outs. Heidelberg stepping up to the plate now for the Vikings. Heidelberg, one of the few players on the varsity roster last year that didn't graduate, only a junior this year. First pitch swinging by him, low curveball in the dirt. It'll be 0-1. Ham takes his lead off of first. Downs looks over at him. He's set. Downs with the pitch. Inside fastball taken for ball one. It's 1-1 here on Heidelberg. Downs with the pitch. Inside curveball. Nearly a strike, but just inside there from Downs. It'll be 2-1 here on Heidelberg. Downs set. The pitch. High fastball there. 3-1 here on Heidelberg. Cameron Williams standing on deck. Ham takes his step off first. Downs. Come set. Leg kick the pitch. It's a fastball. I'm sorry, an off-speed drilled down the line there from Heidelberg. Ham will try to get from first to third. The cut is not in time. Heidelberg advances to second. So it'll be runners on second and third. No outs with Cameron Williams coming up to bat. Two out, or a no out double there from Heidelberg. So now it appears to be a pitching change here for Kenwood. As we have no outs, runners on second and third. Cameron Williams coming up to bat. Kenwood coach having a conversation here with Downs. It appears he's going to stay out here on the mound for at least another batter. So Williams steps up to the plate. We got Stamps on deck. Looking to take advantage of these two runners in scoring position. Downs, starting from the windup. Gets the sign from the catcher. Here's the windup, the pitch. High fastball, but it's called a strike here on Williams. Don't know about that one. Looked a little high and inside. Williams will take it for 0-1. Downs with the pitch. Another fastball. That's going to be called ball one here. 1-1 here on Williams. Downs, wind up, the pitch. It's going to be grounded to second. They're going to get the out at first, but Ham will score from third. So an RBI sacrifice ground out there from Cameron Williams. It'll be 6-4 Kenwood's lead. Stamp stepping up to the plate now with Heidelberg at third. One out, looking to drive Heidelberg in to bring the Vikings within one. Downs yet again from the windup. Here's the pitch. Curveball. Painted on the inside corner. It's going to be strike one here on Stamps. Wind up the pitch. Another curveball painted on the outside corner. 0-2 here on Arthur Stamps. Right fielder 1-for-2 with a home run to left center on the day. Looking to repeat that again. Steps back into the box. Downs gets a sign. The wind up, the pitch. The fastball grounded to Downs. He'll look back Heidelberg at third and throw to first. Get the out. No runner scoring on the play. Here comes Nick Calamino up to bat. 1-for-2 with the single on the day. Downs wind up the pitch. Calamino takes a fastball pay on the outside corner. 0-1. Downs wind up pitch. High fastball called strike two there. Heidelberg takes his lead at third. Downs wind up the pitch. It's a low curveball taken for ball one. 1-2 here with two outs on Nick Calamino. Pitch is high. High and outside there on Calamino. So 2-2 on him now. Jimmy Downs to wind the pitch. Another fastball high and away here on Calamino. Full count now. Kendall Ellis on deck. So 3-2, two outs. Amir Heidelberg at third. Calamino with the full count. Downs wind up pitch. It's a fastball. Popped up sky high. Shortstop's calling for it. And he'll make the catch. So Kenwood Broncos get out of the inning, stranding a runner at third. It'll be 6-4 Broncos lead at the end of the fifth, headed into the top of the sixth. You're watching HF Viking Baseball. Stepping up now for Kenwood, Destin Edwards, left fielder here. Roseboro remains on the mound. As he winds up, throws a pitch. It's going to be outside for ball number one here on Edwards. Roseboro winds, pitch number two of the at-bat. It's called for a strike. Nice changeup there from Roseboro. 1-1 here. Roseboro wind the pitch. Nice curveball there. Just outside, 2-1 here on Edwards. Munoz gives the sign. Roseboro wind the pitch. is fouled back sky high. And it hits a car out of play. So it's going to be 2-2 here on Edwards. Roseboro winding the pitch. Nice off speed there. High. Just called for a ball a bit high. 3-2 full count here on Rose or on Edwards. Roseboro winding the pitch. Curveball called high. It's going to be ball four. It's going to be a walk here from Edwards. Stepping up now is Daniel Luster, catching for Kenwood. Munoz getting the sign from coach. Roseboro takes a sign from Munoz. Checks the runner at first. Wind the pitch. There's a ground ball to Chaney. Chaney will throw to first. Nice play there from Torrey, but Heidelberg just couldn't make the scoop. Cross throw there from Torrey Chaney. Let's check the replay real quick on that one. Running into the gap. Makes a nice throw to first. Heidelberg just couldn't make the scoop. So it'll be runners on first and second with no outs as Jonathan Patterson steps up to the plate. So no batters out, first and second. Patterson at the plate. Roseboro comes set. Steps off, looks at second, does not make a pickoff attempt. Patterson, the eighth hitter in this lineup. Roseboro steps back on the mound. He comes set. Leg kick, the pitch is a shown bunt. And he's called out on the play. So it's going to be a dead ball. He bunted the ball. The ball hit him. He's called out on the play. Believe the runners do have to remain back, but we'll double check that with the umpire. So timeouts being called by the umps to discuss this one. For anyone that doesn't know, if you bunt the ball and run outside the box, if the ball hits you while you are outside of the batter's box, that is called an out. If you are inside the batter's box while the ball hits you after bunting, it is called a foul ball. So on the play, the runner was called out. They said he was out of the batter's box. So yes, the umpires do come out of their meeting. They do keep the runner out. Runners will have to go back to first and second base. They do not get to advance on the play. So a nice break there from the Vikings as it's one out, runners on first and second, and Antonio Porterfield steps up to the plate. Roseboro set the pitch. Nice off-speed curveball there from him, painted on the outside corner. 0-1 here on Porterfield. Roseboro set. Leg kick the pitch. It's another curveball down the pipe here on Porterfield. So now he's in a hole. It's 0-2. Roseboro comes set. Leg kick the pitch. It's lined to left here by Porterfield. Ellis backtracking. Nice catch there by Kendall Ellis. Lost track of the ball for a minute, was backtracking, but made the catch in the end. Stepping up to the plate is Kamari Thomas. Two home runs on the day. We'll see what the Vikings decide to do with him. So it appears they're going to let him hit. Roseboro pitched to him with two outs, trying to get this third out of the inning, leave these runners stranded. Timeout called here by the umpires. It's going to be a pinch runner for the runner at first. Luster, the catcher, running at first, calling a pinch runner for him. So top of the sixth, score is 6-4, Kenwood's lead, up by two. Two outs here in the top of the sixth, Roseboro trying to escape the jam. High, it's called ball one here, 1-0 here on Thomas. Roseboro set, leg kick, the pitch. It's a low changeup, called ball two here on Thomas. Roseboro wanted a strike, just didn't get it. So 2-0 here on Thomas. See if Roseboro can get out of this. Like, kick the pitch. Another low curveball here. It'll be 3-0 here on Kamari Thomas. Not the biggest thing to walk him with two outs. Obviously a threat at the plate with two home runs here. So wouldn't be the end of the world if Roseboro let him walk. Roseboro set. Here comes the pitch. 3-0 pitch is an outside fastball. Call for ball four. Thomas will advance the first on the walk. Up to bat is now Damarion Butler. Stepping up here with the bases loaded, two outs, trying to do something to extend Kenwood's lead. Forced at any base here for the Vikings. Roseboro just trying to get a ball in play and get an out. Roseboro set. The pitch. The high curveball, it's going to be ball one. So now five straight balls from Trent Roseboro. Roseboro set the pitch. Swing and a miss here from Butler. 1-1. Nice comeback there, pitch there from Roseboro. Outside fastball painted. So 1-1 here. Roseboro set. Leg kick the pitch. Another fastball right down the pipe called strike two here on Butler. Big pitch there from Roseboro. 1-2 here. Trying to escape this jam. Bases loaded here for Kenwood. Two outs. 1-2 pitch. Here it comes. Curveball there called high. 2-2 here. Tried to bury that curveball, but let it go a little early. Roseboro wasn't too happy with that. So he'll come set, ready for the 2-2. Pitch. Curveball swing and a miss here. Great pitch there from Roseboro as the Vikings escape it. Huge moment there from Trent Roseboro. Gets the strikeout and the third out. So heading into the bottom of the sixth, the score is Kenwood 6, Homewood Flossmoor 4. You're watching Homewood Flossmoor Vikings baseball. New pitcher here for the Broncos is going to be Kamari Thomas. Kendall Ellis steps up to the plate, looking to bring the Vikings closer. Maybe tie this game up going into the seventh. Maybe even take the lead. So he'll lead it off for the Vikings. No outs here as they try to start some. On deck is going to be Mateo Munoz. After him, Mateo Morales. And then back up to the top of the lineup with Torrey Chaney. Thomas set the pitch. Inside fastball, called the strike here on Ellis. Ellis didn't like the call, thought it was about to hit him. But it's 0-1 here on Kendall Ellis. The pitch, another fastball outside this time, 0-2 here. The pitch from Thomas. Foul back here by Ellis. It will remain 0-2 count. Three straight fastballs now from Kamari Thomas. We'll see if he changes it up here on the fourth pitch to Ellis. Moving quick, coming from the stretch. Thomas set a pitch. Another fastball outside. Super close, but it's called ball. 1-2. Thomas, the pitch. High fastball. Ball number two. We've seen that pitch called before. Didn't know if it was going to be this time. Still 2-2 here on Ellis. Thomas set the pitch. Line down the line there by Ellis. It's going to drop for a single. Left fielder was debating if he was going to go for it or not, but let it drop. It'll be a no-out single here for Ellis. Now Mateo Morales come up to the plate, trying to keep the rally going. Thomas, the pitch. Inside on Munoz, 1-0. First lefty pitcher that the Vikings have seen all season. Hopefully Ellis doesn't get fooled by lefty pickoff move at first. Morales now stepping up to the plate. No outs for the Vikings, down 6-4, bottom of the sixth inning. Thomas comes set, looks back at Ellis. Here's the pitch. Munoz fouls it off. It'll be 1-1 now here on the catcher. Thomas set the pitch. Morales shows bunt. He lays it down. It's going to be a foul ball. So maybe trying to advance Ellis to second. But now 1-2 the count. Morales now 1-2. Thomas comes set. The pitch. Low fastball. Called for a ball. 2-2 now on Munoz. Ball three. No, strike three called on Munoz. So first out of the inning for Kenwood. Stepping up now is Mateo Morales, ninth hitter of this lineup. Ellis remains at first. Trying to keep something going here is Morales. Thomas, the pitch. He shows bunt as well. Lays it down foul down the line. Ellis takes his lead at first. Thomas comes set. The pitch. Swing and a miss by Morales. 0-2 now. Torrey Chaney on deck with a home run on the day. Thomas pitch. Ellis goes to second. Pitches. Throw is wild to second. So Ellis will go from first to third. He's called safe at third. He'll go from first to third. Stole second. Pitch got away. Went to third. The throw to third was close, but he was called safe on the play. So now Morales is just trying to put a ball in play to try to score Ellis here from third. Count is 1-2 here on Mateo Morales. Thomas set. Here's the pitch. Ball is low. 2-2 now. Pitch from Thomas is high. Full count on Mateo Morales here. Thomas comes set. The payoff pitch. Fouled off by Morales. Ball's going to be out of play. Hi. So Morales is going to take the one out walk. Here comes Torrey Chaney. One out runners on first and third here. Pitching coach will come out for Kenwood. So a team will disperse. One out, runners on first and third for the Vikings. Up to bat is Torrey Chaney. Morales at first, Ellis at third. Trying to drive in a run or two to give the Vikings the tie. So he steps up. Thomas looks at Morales. Comes set. Back. Thomas picks off Morales at first. Pickoff move is no good. Morales stays there. So Thomas comes set. He throws back to first again. Morales back safe. Thomas asks him to redo the signs. He comes set. The pitch. High. Ball number one on Chaney. Gonna be 1-0. Thomas set. Chaney swing and a miss. Morales goes to second on the pitch. He'll be safe. So runners on second, third, count 1-1 for Torrey Chaney. So now two runners in scoring position for Chaney. Trying to tie this game up with a knock to the outfield. Thomas, the pitch. Low pitch fouled off towards the back screen. It's 1-2 here on Chaney. Here comes the pitch from Thomas. Off speed, high and away, 2-2 here on Chaney. Pitch here from Thomas. It's a fastball tipped off by Chaney, staying alive. Count remains 2-2. Still one out only for the Vikings here. 2-2 the count on Chaney, staying alive. Two foul balls in a row. Pitch from Thomas. Another foul ball down the right field line. Still 2-2 for Chaney. Chaney battling here at the plate, trying to get these runners home. Thomas steps back on the mound. Come set. Morales with a big lead at second. Thomas set the pitch. High. High and outside. Great take there by Chaney. Full count here on him. Ricky Hamm on deck for the Vikings. Thomas set. Leg kick the pitch. Another high fastball here on Chaney. So bases loaded here for Ricky Hamm. We'll see what he can do for the Vikings. So as Chaney takes the walk, it'll be Ellis on third, Morales on second, and Chaney at first. Opening night here for the Vikings. Beautiful day for baseball, about 50 degrees here. Still late at night. Almost 7 o'clock here. So Vikings only down by two. Ricky Hamm could change this game with one swing. Bottom of the sixth. Thomas steps back on the mound. Hamm steps into the plate. Thomas comes set. Pick off to second. No good. Morales gets back in time. Maybe a coordinated play there from the huddle. Thomas set. The pitch from Hamm. Low changeup here from Thomas. 1-0 here on Hamm. One out still only here for the Vikings. Thomas set the pitch. Another low fastball here from Thomas. 2-0 here on Ricky Hamm. Thomas set, payoff pitch. Swing and a miss here from Hamm. Hard swing there from Ricky Hamm, trying to knock that ball out. Thomas the pitch. Fouled off by Hamm. It'll be 2-2 here on Ricky Hamm. Thomas. Looking at the signs. Taking off the catcher a few times now. Here comes the pitch. Off speed. Did he go? He did. Swing is called here on Hamm. So it'll be two outs now for the Vikings. And up to bat will step Demir Heidelberg. Thomas comes set. Here's the pitch. Heidelberg fouls one off to the right. 0-1 here. Thomas is set. The pitch. Heidelberg grounds it. It's through first and second. Ellis will score. Morales on his way home. He's safe. Wild throw. Chaney will advance to third. Demir to second. It'll be 6-6. The game is all tied up here late in the game in the bottom of the sixth inning. Thank you. So it's all tied up here. Runners on second and third for Cameron Williams here. Clutch hit there from Heidelberg right between the first and second baseman. Scored two runs on the bases loaded knock. So now two outs, all tied up here late in the game for the Vikings. Thomas will come set. The pitch to Williams. Call the strike here. Thomas gets the ball back. He's set. And the pitch. Outside here on Williams, 1-1. Time called by Williams. Arthur Stamps on deck for the Vikings. 1-1 pitch. Here it is. Williams fouls it off to the right. It'll be 1-2 here on Cam Williams. Thomas set. The pitch. Knocked to right field by Cam Williams. It's going to get down. Williams will get to second on the play. Two runs will score. Cameron Williams with the go-ahead double. Check out the replay on that one. A nice knock by Williams over the right fielder's head. Cameron will get two on the play. Two runs score and a two-out, two-run double in the late game. Bottom of the sixth inning for Cameron Williams. Score now 8-6. Vikings lead late against Kenwood. And Arthur Stamps will step to the plate with Williams on second. Great hit there from Cam. He's excited, jumping back into the dugout. Pinch runner called. It'll be Kamen Robertson running for Williams at second. Stamps stepping up to the plate, trying to pad in this lead a little bit, give the Vikings a little bit of insurance. So Kamari Thomas stays on the mound for the Broncos to face Arthur Stamps. Two outs, score is 8-6, Vikings lead. Robertson on second. Here's the pitch. Inside fastball, ball one here on Stamps. Clutch hit there from Williams to give the Vikings a two-run lead. Second pitch is fouled back here by Stamps. It'll be out of play. 1-1 here, count on Stamps. Stamps count 1-1 on him. Thomas comes set. The pitch. Outside ball two here on Stamps, 2-1. The pitch. Stamps follows it back again. It'll be 2-2. So count 2-2 here on Stamps as he steps back into the box. Thomas is set. The pitch. Fouled off of Stamps, fouled off of his leg. Stays 2-2. Thomas comes set. Pitch to Stamps. It's outside fastball for ball three. 3-2 now on Arthur Stamps. Full count with two outs. Robertson at second. Vikings lead 8-6. Bottom of the sixth inning. Thomas the pitch. Low. Ball four here on Stamps. So it'll be runners on first and second, and Nick Calamino will come to the plate. Calamino trying to give the Vikings a bit of insurance, going to the top of the seventh to try to close this game out. Thomas, the pitch. High. Calls for a strike. Kerbalker looked a bit high. Called a strike. Calamino didn't like the call, but it's 0-1. The kick, the pitch from Thomas. Low fastball in the dirt, stopped by a catcher. It'll be 1-1. Thomas, the pitch. Low fastball called for ball two. 2-1 here on Calamino. Ball three on Calamino. 3-1 now. Ellis on deck. Thomas, the payoff pitch. It's fouled off by Calamino. This will be full count. Reynolds will be on the move on the pitch with two outs. Robertson on second. Stamps on first. We'll see what Calamino does here with the full count. 8-6, Vikings lead, bottom of the sixth. Full count, two outs. The pitch. Oh, he steps off. No pickoff attempt. Looks back at Kamen Robertson at second, but Robertson got back at time. No one to cover at second. So set is Thomas. The pitch is fouled off yet again by Calamino. That one will get out of play. Remains a full count here for Nick Calamino. Thomas now. And it's ball four. Calamino will take the walk. Bases loaded. It'll be Kendall Ellis' second at bat of the inning. So Ellis stepping up to the plate. His second at bat of the inning. Now. Thomas looking to retire Ellis. Bases loaded. Two outs. Vikings lead by 2-8-6. Ball one here on Ellis. Here's a pitch. Ball two, high and outside here from Thomas. Two and oh here on Kendall Ellis. Base is fully loaded. Thomas, kick and the pitch. It's low. 3-0 here on Kendall Ellis. Can't find the strike zone here. Walk on the batter of a four. Now three consecutive balls. Ball four here on Ellis. So that'll pad the Vikings lead. 9-6 now. And this will be the last bat. That was the last batter here for Kamari Thomas. So the Vikings lead 9-6. Still bottom of the sixth. Mateo Munoz coming up for a second at bat of the inning. Coming in a pitch now for Kenwood, number two, Demarion Butler. Here's the windup, the pitch to Munoz. Ball one, low here on Mateo Munoz. Vikings lead now 9-6. 9-6 lead here from the Vikings, bottom of the sixth. The pitch. Munoz with a big swing, fouled back. It'll be 1-1 now. Butler, wind up the pitch. Strike two called on Munoz, 1-2 now. Here's the pitch from Butler. Fouled off, way out of play by Munoz. Butler, wind up the pitch. High. Moving fast here. Munoz steps in the box. Butler goes right to the pitch. So it'll be 2-2 here on Munoz. Butler with the windup, the pitch. High. Sky high here by Munoz. And it's caught. So that'll be a third out of a long inning here by the Vikings. They score 5 in the inning. So it'll be 9-6 Vikings going into the top of the 7th. Zach Bernath will come in and try to close this game out. We'll be right back. So Zach Bernath coming in to pitch for the Vikings. Stepping up for Kenwood's number 21, Savion Flowers. Try to lead things off for the Broncos. So here comes Bernath with the Y and the pitch. Inside fastball, call the ball. 1-0 on Flowers. Bernath the Y and the pitch. Another inside fastball spiked in the dirt. 2-0 now on Flowers. Bernath the wind the pitch. Strike one down the pipe here on Flowers. 1-2-1 now on Savion Flowers. Bernath the wind the pitch. Another fastball spiked in the dirt. 3-1 now on Flowers. Bernath, wine, the pitch. High fastball called ball four here on Flowers. So getting into some early trouble here. Walking the first batter. Now up to bat is Jimmy Downs. Downs taken out of the game in the sixth inning. Pitch through five. Remained in the game as the DH now. Bernath the pitch. Another low off speed. 1-0 on Downs. Here's Bernath the pitch. Strike one called. Good comeback pitch there by Bernath. So it'll be 1-1 here on Downs. Bernath comes set, pick off to first. He gets back in time. Bernath comes set again. Kick the pitch. Fouled off by Downs. It'll be 1-2 on Jimmy Downs. Bernath the pitch. Low in the dirt. Munoz can't scoop it up. So Flowers will get to second on the pitch. 2-2 here on Downs. Curveball spiked in the dirt. Bounced up between Munoz's legs. Couldn't stop it. So now a runner in scoring position with no outs for the Broncos. Bernath the pitch. Another pitch in the dirt here. Flowers will get to third now. Three and two here on Downs. Trying to put him away. Bernath gets set. Here's the pitch. Fouled off yet again by Downs. Count will remain 3-2. Flowers on third, no outs. Vikings lead 9-6 in the top of the seventh. Bernath, come set the pitch. High. Ball four on Downs here. So it'll be runners at the corners with no outs here. And stepping up is Philip Thigpen. Big Pen stepping up to the plate now. Bernat stays on the mound. No outs for the Broncos. Runners on first and third. Bernat trying to get the save here and secure the Vikings' first win of the season. Steps off. Trying to settle himself. So Bernat steps back on the mound. He gets set. Pick off to first. No good. Runner gets back in time. Bernat gets set. Here's the pitch. High fastball here on Thigpen. 1-0. Bernat set again. The kick, the pitch. Strike right down the pipe there. Nice comeback pitch there by Bernat. 1-1 now on Thigpen. Bernat gets set. Here's the next pitch. Another high inside fastball by Bernat. 2-1 now. Bernat, they kick the pitch. It's fouled back up towards the press box. 2-2. Trying to get the first out of the inning here. Downs at first. Flowers at third. They kick the pitch. Curveball there, fouled out yet again. It'll remain 2-2 here on Thigpen. For an athlete, kick the pitch. Another low curveball there in the dirt. 3-2 now. Still no outs for the Vikings. Runners on the corners. Bernat taking a deep breath. Step back on the mound. And the kick. The pitch. Called ball four. Controversial call there. Looked like a strike from up here. Umpire down there didn't see it the same. Called it a bit low. So it's going to be bases loaded here for the Broncos. Dustin Edwards stepping up to the plate. Bernat trying to pull off a miracle here. Bernat comes set. Here's the pitch. Ball low. Oh, 1-0 now. Bernat the pitch. Another low fastball. 2-0 now on Edwards. Bernat the pitch. 3-0 now on Dustin Edwards. Three straight fastballs low. Ball four here on Edwards. A four pitch walk here by Bernat. So Homewood Flossmore's lead cut to 2 now. Score 7-9. Still no outs in the inning. Coach Marcus Rogers will go to the mound to talk to Bernath. Cormac Saunders coming in now for the Vikings to try to put this game away. Cormac. Stepping up now for the Broncos, Daniel Luster. Still no outs for the Vikings. Cormac Saunders trying to put this game away for once. Vikings only lead by two, bases loaded for the Broncos. Saunders gets set. The pitch. Strike one called, fastball down the middle. So now 0-1 here on Luster. Saunders steps off the mound. Saunders set. And the pitch. 0-2 slider off the end of the plate. Called for a strike. 0-2 now on Luster. Saunders set. The pitch. Fouled off into the stands. Out of play. Remains 0-2 for Saunders. Trying to put Luster away. Get that first out. Here's the pitch from Saunders. Fastball jammed, fouled off down the line. Out of play. Still 0-2 on Luster. Saunders set the pitch. 0-2 curveball looked like a good pitch. Not called though. 1-2 still. Saunders set the pitch. Strike three called! Huge pitch from Cormac Saunders there to get the first out of the inning. So Luster is retired, and here comes Jonathan Patterson. One out for the Vikings. Bases loaded, up by two. Saunders the pitch. Strike one called on a fastball down the pipe. Second pitch here from Saunders. It's a fastball line to center field. It's right to Calamino. Runners will tag. One run will score on the play. So it'll be 8-9. Broncos are within one. But an out on the play. So Vikings lead by one. With two outs, runners on the corners, and here comes Antonio Porterfield. So they appeal him. The runner at second left too early. The runner at second had left too early. So the Vikings win the game in tremendous fashion. That's a third out of the game. Final score is 9-8. Vikings win. So the Vikings go 1-0 on the season as they face Eisenhower tomorrow at 5 o'clock. That's all I have for you today. We hope to see you at the game tomorrow. Home game, Eisenhower here at the Varsity Field. We'll see you tomorrow. Vikings win, go 1-0 of the season. Final score, Homewood Flossmoor 9, Kenwood 8.